Hello students, previously we have discussed about how to describe a location of a place using one latitude and one longitude and how to describe the extent of a region using two parallels of a latitude and two meridians of a longitude of their extreme endpoints. Today, we are going to learn how to describe a extent of linear features like a river, roads, etc. For describing the extent of linear features like a river, road, etc., we need to consider the latitude and longitude of their terminal points. For example, the river Nile in Africa originates in Lake Victoria, located in modern days Uganda, Tanzania and Kenya, flows from south to north and meets the Mediterranean Sea near the city of Alexandria in Egypt and Sudan. The River Nile is the largest river in the world. The River Nile has a length of about 6,695 kilometers. And now, we will try to find out the extent of the River Nile in the map of Africa. The River Nile in Africa originates in Lake Victoria. Look at this location of Lake Victoria. Located in modern day Uganda, Tanzania, and Kenya. The River Nile originates in a Lake Victoria, flows from south to the north. Look at this. South to the north and meets to the Mediterranean Sea. Near the city of Alexandria in Egypt. So this is a point where the River Nile meets to Mediterranean Sea. So, we need to consider the location of originate point of the River Nile, Lake Victoria, and the point where the Nile River meet to Mediterranean Sea in Egypt. For describing the extent of linear features like a River Nile, we need to consider the latitude and longitude of their terminal points. These are terminal points of the River Nile, Lake Victoria, and city of Alexandria in Egypt. The location of Lake Victoria is a 0° 45′ 21″ south latitude. Here approximately I will show. And 33° 26′ 18″ east longitude. Approximately I will draw the longitude. Similarly, the location of a place where the River Nile meets to Mediterranean Sea is, look at this point, where the Nile River meets to Mediterranean Sea is 31 degree 12 minute north lat. And 29 degree 55 minute 7 second east longitude.
So these latitudes and longitudes are considered to describe the extent of the river Nile.
This extent is from 0 degree 45 minute south latitude and 33 degree 26 minute east longitude. This is the originate point of the river Nile, and 31 degree 12 minute north latitude and 29 degree 55 minute east longitude. This is the point where the river Nile meets to Mediterranean Sea.
And now let us use the graticule. Answer the following questions about location and extent with the help of figure number 2.3. Look at this figure number 2.3. It is a map of Brazil, which latitude and longitude define the location of the capital of Brazil, Brasilia. And now see the location of Brasilia, capital of country Brazil. This is a 0 degree equator, 10 degree latitude in southern hemisphere. So we have to express 10 degree south latitude passes near Brasilia. This is a 20 degree south latitude, so we have to consider 10 degree south latitude for describing a location of Brasilia. So one more latitude we have to draw here passes through Brasilia, and a degree of this latitude will be approximately 14 degree south latitude. Now see this longitude passes near Brasilia, 50 degree west longitude. This is a 40 degree west longitude. For describing a location of Brasilia, one more longitude we have to draw that passes through Brasilia. And what would be degree of this longitude? 48 degree west longitude approximately. Next question: what would be the longitudinal extent of Brazil that spreads from 5 degree 15 minute north to 33 degree 45 minute south latitude? See the latitudinal extent of Brazil. This is a 0 degree equator. This is the extreme end point of Brazil towards north. We have to consider this latitude for describing latitudinal extent of Brazil. The degree of this latitude is a 5 degree 15 minutes north latitude. And this is the extreme endpoint of Brazil towards south. We have to consider this latitude. Look at this 30 degree south latitude, and a degree of this latitude would be 33 degree 45 minute south latitude. So this is a latitudinal extent of Brazil. Now we will see longitudinal extent of Brazil. Look at this extreme endpoint of Brazil towards west. This is a 50 degree west longitude, 60 degree west longitude, 70 degree west longitude. And this is the extreme end point of Brazil towards west. What is the degree of this longitude? Approximately 73 degree west longitude. And now look at this extreme end point of Brazil towards the east. Look at this 40 degree west longitude. One can draw 30 degree west longitude. And this is the extreme end point of Brazil towards the east. The degree of this longitude would be approximately 34 degree west longitude. So this is a longitudinal extent of Brazil. That means east-west extent of Brazil. Next question. In which hemispheres does Brazil extends in the north-south direction? This is a north-south extent of Brazil. It is in a northern hemisphere as well southern hemisphere. Next question. In which hemisphere does Brazil extend in the east-west direction? Brazil extends in east-west direction in western hemisphere. See this longitudinal extent, 73 degree west longitude and 34 degree west longitude. So Brazil located in western hemisphere. Next question. Which parallels and meridians should be used to describe the extent of a river São Francisco? So for describing a location of a linear feature like a river, we have to consider one parallel and one meridian of their originate point. This is the originate point of the river São Francisco, and this is a ending point, or here the river São Francisco meets to Atlantic Ocean. So we have to consider one parallel and one meridian of this point. Now look at this originate point of river São Francisco. The river São Francisco originates in the mountain ranges of Minas Gerais in Brazil. So for describing the extent of river São Francisco, we have to consider one latitude and one longitude of its originate points. Look at this 20 degrees south latitude passes near the originate point of the river São Francisco. The latitude of this point where the river São Francisco originates is approximately 18 degree south latitude. So along with the latitude, we have need one longitude also. So here one can draw longitude passes through the originate point of the river São Francisco. And what would be degree of this longitude? Approximately 44 degree west longitude. And look at this point where the river São Francisco meets to Atlantic Ocean. So we have to consider one latitude and one longitude of this point, Atlantic Ocean. what would be degree of this latitude? Approximately 9 degree south latitude. And just see this 40 degree west longitude. One can draw that passes through point where the river São Francisco meets to Atlantic Ocean. And what would be degree of this longitude? Approximately 36 degree west longitude. Next question. Describe the location of Marajo Island using the gravity kiln. See the location of Marajo Island, very close to the equator, and the latitude of Marajo Island is approximately 0.005 degree north latitude, because Marajo Island located very close towards the equator. And just see this 50 degree west longitude. This is the location of Marajo Island, and one can draw the meridian that passes through Marajo Island. What would be degree of this longitude? Approximately 51 degree west longitude. Students, thus we have learned that how to use a gravity kiln for describing a location of a place, extent of a region, and extent of a linear feature precisely with the help of gravity kiln system.